In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to create a Dolby Vision IMF supplemental package for picture using DaVinci Resolve Studio. To create an IMF supplemental package, open your Dolby Vision IMF project. Create a new bin and drop the complete Dolby Vision IMF package into the media pool. Right-click on the clip name and select Create New Timeline using Composition Playlist. Assign a name of your choice and press Save to have Resolve create a new timeline. During this process, Resolve will also extract and import the Dolby Vision metadata from the Dolby Vision IMF package. Now, move to the color page and navigate to the Dolby Vision tab. As you can see, there's now a new tone map using drop-down with the following options. Custom metadata would allow the user to run a new Dolby Vision analysis. Embedded metadata would again extract and import the Dolby Vision metadata from the Dolby Vision IMF. And the original metadata option will use the metadata that was extracted from the imported Dolby Vision IMF while creating a new timeline. Select original metadata to link the imported metadata to the timeline. When importing IMFs, Resolve currently applies a single, global aspect ratio to all shots in the timeline, even if there are shots that have a different blanking value. This applies to version 18.1.2 that was used to create this video and may change in a future version. Navigate to Timeline, Output Blanking, and click Reset to restore the original blanking settings from the IMF. Once done, run a quick QC pass and check the mapping to SDR to confirm that the IMF along with the metadata was imported correctly. Now, navigate back to the media page and drop in the shots that need to be replaced in the IMF. Using Resolve's edit function, select the first shot that needs correction and replace it on video track 1. The shot replacement contains only a minor dead pixel correction, so we can safely reuse the original metadata. Go to the color page in the Dolby Vision tab and select tone mapping using original metadata for this shot. In the second shot to be changed, an incorrect blanking was applied, and the HDR color grade was adjusted as well. Therefore, the colorist has explicitly created new Dolby Vision metadata and delivered a new XML file that solely contains the metadata for this shot. To import the metadata, navigate back to the color page, select the Dolby Vision palette, navigate to the options menu, and select Import Metadata from XML. Now, set tone map using to imported metadata. When you are importing Dolby Vision metadata into a newly inserted shot, Resolve aligns the start frame of the metadata file to the beginning of that replaced shot. For such scenarios, it is important to use a separate metadata file that contains only the required corrections for that particular shot. The tone map using feature lets you select which metadata to apply to each shot. Let's go back to the edit page again and right-click on the two shots we have replaced so far. We can verify that Resolve automatically inserts them into the supplemental IMF package. The last shot to be changed required a revised trim for the SDR target, and the colorist has supplied an updated version of the original XML file that now contains new trim metadata for that shot. Isolate this shot and now go back to the color page to import its adjusted metadata. When you are importing Dolby Vision metadata into an existing shot, Resolve aligns the start frame of the metadata file to the beginning of the timeline. For such scenarios, it is important to use an updated version of the original metadata. Now, back on the edit page, right-click on this shot and select Include Clip in Supplemental Package to have this metadata change included in the supplemental IMF as well. Remember that Dolby Vision metadata inside a Dolby Vision IMF is interleaved with the video essence, so any metadata change must also be accompanied by the corresponding video clip inside the supplemental. Go back to the color page and check and ensure that all the changes work as expected. Next, navigate to the Deliver page and select the IMF parameters to match the complete Dolby Vision IMF we used to make these edits. For this video, we'll use the Netflix preset. Choose a file name and render location for the Dolby Vision IMF supplemental render. Select Supplemental Package. Navigate to Composition Settings and ensure that the content kind matches the original version, in this case, EPS episode. Then, go to the Audio tab and ensure that Output Track 1 is set to Timeline Track, and ensure that Export as Dolby Atmos IMF IAB is checked. Click Edit Metadata and check the language code as well as the right content kind. Once you have reviewed all your settings and everything looks good, you can add this render to the render queue. As you can see, Resolve only renders the newly inserted patches. To review the Dolby Vision IMF supplemental, go back to the Media page and import the rendered supplemental package into the same project. If you create a new project, Resolve will not know where the complete Dolby Vision IMF package is located and will therefore show its content as offline. Right-click on the imported Dolby Vision IMF and choose Create New Timeline using Composition Playlist. Name the new timeline and press Create. Resolve will create a new bin in the media pool that contains the patches you inserted. Now, go to the Color page, reset the timeline blanking, and set tone mapping to original metadata for all shots individually. Verify the changes made in HDR as well as on the SDR mapped output,